Mr. Underwood, would you like to address questions, concerns?
I believe we have 27 seconds left. Just to say, we object to standing if you have any punch for some. We'll state that the runners let her speak for itself. Chair Paxton has raised concerns and the names will be standing.
I'd like you to address what the opposition was asking for from his letter. A no signage of any kind, 50-foot setback from center line, and the lighting of any athletic volleyball courts.
The lighting has been addressed. We propose a zoning condition that, quite frankly, mirrors the UDC as far as light spillage, 1-foot candle against residential properties, and 2-foot candles against some public roads. As far as the 50-foot, there is absolutely no way that can be done.
Okay, we've objected to the time period they're from and asked for our rebuttal.
Well, that is it. That is the time, correct? That's it?
No, we had some rebuttal time.
Okay. If I may remind the chair, that the chair has the discretion in the UDC to extend equal amounts of time to either side.
Well, I'd like to give Ethan another 2 minutes of time to finish what he was saying.
I think they still have, the opposition still has some time.
We have 5:18 left on the opposition.
Yes, so they can use their 5:18. And I think, Ethan, you will finish, correct?
Yes, ma'am. And that's fine. And we just would like to make our constitutional arguments at this time. The approval of this CUP would violate my client's federal, state, constitutional rights. I have to make that argument now. That's about it. Like I say, this is a church. We all know it. The records are replete with it. You want to put it in a community center on a road that's high impact. This is what Sheriff Patterson says in his letter, saying that it's a very high area of traffic, and you want to put it in a place where they ride bicycles, you know, to the place, it just doesn't make any sense, and we'll take this up in the spirit of the board. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any other opposition?
When I arrived, there were no sign-in sheets, so I'm happy to fill them out after I speak. My name is Nydia Tisdale. I live in Roswell, Georgia. I have no interest in this matter whatsoever, other than education and entertainment, actually. And I would also like to take this time to introduce you to the Forsyth County Attorney with Gerard and Davis. And as Forsyth County public officials, if you have legal questions about business before the board, you have a duty and an obligation to consult legal counsel hired and retained by Forsyth County, not the zoning applicant's attorney. Thank you.
Any other opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
I have a question about this.
Well, we need to close the public hearing. Is there a motion?
Well, I need to ask it of the public.
Well, we're going to close the public hearing first.
Can I ask a question of the audience?
After we close the public hearing, if everyone agrees, yes. Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So.
Second.
All in favor? Would anyone like to make a motion or discussion?
Okay. I'd like to ask Ethan a question. I'm sure it was an oversight, you know, when you were giving your discussion of what the sheriff said in his letter to Jill Martin. But I'd like for you to comment on the last sentence, or the next to the last sentence in his letter, where it says, in addition, there's potential for this center to increase the amount of vehicular traffic on Crystal Cove Trail, which could increase the risk of public safety in the area. And the vehicular traffic is a zoning issue. Can you respond to what the sheriff says about that, or give us Bridgepoint's point of view as to the sheriff's
concern? The sheriff is not here. He's issued a concern. But as long as we can address the concerns, then he'll be satisfied. He's not stating that he's in opposition, but this saying addition is potential for the center to increase the amount of people to attract. I don't believe that the sheriff is aware that we've also worked with the planning department to make sure that we facilitate bicycle parking and to accommodate pedestrian and bicycle access to this site. Respectfully, the sheriff is not aware of this community zoning here.
You didn't make him aware of that when you, didn't you discuss it with him?
I did make him aware of that.
So he is aware of it.
As of this morning.
Mr. Underwood?
However, if I make Dr. Moses.
Well, just one question.
I'd rather not put words in the sheriff's mouth.
Mr. Underwood, just one, Dr. Moses, I intend on talking to the sheriff. This is a project in District 4. When I read this letter.
We'd object to this being part of public hearing. It's closed.
Dr. Moses, I just want to let you know that I look at this letter, and it's clear to me that the sheriff may not have been given all the information. I'm going to ask him to review the public hearing information, all the information in the file, and then sit down and talk to me about it. I don't believe this letter was rendered with full information.
Good idea.
Thank you.
I support what you're doing.
Okay. I think that concludes the public hearing is closed. Is there a motion?
I'd like to make a motion that we approve Bridgepoint Community Network CP 100011 to send it to the Board of Commissioners with our recommendation of approval with the following conditions. One, the structure shall be constructed to have a residential appearance. Two, no signage of any kind, whether temporary or permanent, will be permitted. I would like to delete conditions 2 and 3 as presented and substitute that the developer shall dedicate right-of-way 25 feet from the center line of Crystal Cove Trail and Thunder Trail as recommended by Forsyth County Engineering Department and shall comply with the 50-foot right-of-way easement as mandated on the revised plat of this property dated March 18, 2011 for Bill 11 by McWhorter and Anderson Land Surveying and Engineering. Also, I'd like to delete the proposed lighting conditions and substitute lighting of any athletic activities such as volleyball or basketball courts shall be prohibited. Also, no outside amplified sound of any kind will be permitted. And also, staff planning zoning department conditions number 1 to require bicycle rack to serve 12 bicycles shall be in full force and leave any other conditions on there other than the ones that I have stated we should delete.
Have a motion, do we have a second?
Madam Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we send CP 1001 to the Board of Commissioners for recommendation of approval with conditions as shown. Also, an additional condition, no outside amplified sound, no commercial lighting, no signage.
We've got a motion, we have a second.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries. All declining? Motion carries. Is there a motion for adjournment?
I believe.
Second. All in favor? Motion carries.
Nice you could be here so quickly.
Yes, anytime.
I'm curious about one.
Yes, sir.
How do your grandfather something in that's never used for that purpose?
Right, it was a public utility, it was a well wash, and so I don't believe it was intended to be a residence. It served as a utility for their water.
You can tell us something, or and you still can't figure out why.
It is a mystery. I agree.
Nice meeting you. I think you did outstanding work.
Oh, thank you so much.
So, what did you study?
I'm okay. I'm not surprised. I'm okay. It's my mother. She's one of the people who needs so much help.
Just come up here so you can bring the name back to the financial.